welcome to the Faz from the Past maintenance tape. We'll be taking it to a different location for this tape, as this building may fit the requirements. We need somewhere more professional, per se, to help our friend Freddy Fazbear right here. So come along. Here we begin our second tape. We have moved to a second location known to be in Utah. I don't remember the town of this place is called, I'm gonna be completely honest. But anyways, let us move to the back area where we can begin. And here we have our good friend Freddy Fazbear. They have been down for some time, and thus I will be trying to show you how to do maintenance on an animatronic in our establishment. To begin off, we must open the mask for checking Clarendo's head. Yes, to put into words. So you have to press their cheeks and give them some pats, you know. And then you have to press their nose. And then you have opened the mask successfully. To begin opening the jar to see the music box, and if it's working properly, press the two bottom teeth right here. And only these two teeth, or else it will chomp down on your hand and eat it like a baguette.
Let the fries bear,
if I may. Now you have to check the speaker manually. You have to put your head close to it, though do not put your head so close to where the teeth are. And as aforementioned, your head might just get chomped off. Let's be honest, we can't have another 83 incident. Or an 87 incident. Yeah, the music box looks like it's working. So you have to close this. As much as I hate it, you have to press the two top teeth right up there, like the bottom teeth. So, and then, in order to close the mask, you have to press the nose of the animatronic. So, before, you must press this button specifically. No other buttons. If you find any other black buttons, that's probably not a button, let's be honest. Anyway, so in order to open both of the eyes, you must press both of these eyebrows simultaneously. Do it fast, but not hard. Alright? So, on 3, 2, 1. It seems this one has a slight malfunction right now. Alright. So, we have to replace one of the eyes, it sees, because the other one just doesn't want to open. Though, we should probably replace the other one. It's shattered. That's probably not too awesome. So, in order to do this, reopen the mask. Alright. So, we have opened the mask. I had to cut it out for... I will have it cut out. But, in order to remove the eye, you must go behind the mask. Or the eye, I mean. Not the mask. Anyways, you have to get real behind there. Let me grab the camera real quick. So, real careful about it. So, there is a button right there. Right there where I'm pointing. You have to press it, and it should unhinge the eye to where you could remove it. I'll remove this process, as I know some people are uncomfortable with removal eyes. However, we will cut to the next part. I will need to close this mask, however, like this. Doo, doo. For the continuing tape, you must not remove the eyelids, as well you need the eyelids, and it's a very functioning part of the robot. So in order, you'll have to grab one of these eyes, in order to, and then put it back into the socket of the animatronic. Now I must bring my camera over here. Oh. So, you have to grab this, put it inside of the eye. Well, you have to take this out, of course, you know. And then put the eye back in there. Put that back in. Make sure the wiring is not damaged at all. Now, this is a different model, but it has a very similar system for the eye. So, it will be all for the eye part. So, let us go back and see the result. Come on. So, after reinstalling the eye, with the instructions handed to you, there should be a chance where you press both of these teeth up here, doo-doo, and then press the nose. Doo-doo. And now, once the mask is closed, you have to try and open the eyes again. Doo-doo. And then it works. This will be the end of this maintenance tape. I fucked it up. For this section, this part, we'll be required to remove the chest part. However, I will not be able to record it as well. It's kind of cramped in here, even though it's not. I'm just making an excuse so I don't have to record more. So, in order to remove the chest hinges, you have to press the bottom button first, the second button first up here, and then pull on the bow tie. So, after removing the chest, we have to look around for a bit. There isn't much maintenance that is done within this area of the body, however, it is a very important part. So, it would be recommended if you test the ball, sockets, and such, the motors, in order to keep it working. If the wire is messed up, we have to contact the electrician, the animatronic manufacturer, as licensed in the booklet that you've been given. So, as for now, this is the only thing that is not that much, say, vulnerable against all odds. However, you might want to check the eye, the arm, the neck motor, and the leg motor. However, that is not a requirement today, so I will not be required to do that. Once you are done with that, you will have to put the chest back on. You will need to put the chest back on. I count how many times I've said chest, Gerald. Here. After putting the chest back on, now I have neglected to give information about getting it on and off. There is a back strap on the animatronic. And it looks like Velcro. It's hard to spot, but it's there. So you have to put the back on. At the head, I don't know much on how to do that, but there's some Velcro steps to avoid messing with the head. It's somewhere around the shoulders and such. Once in order to hinge it back on, you'll need to press the bow tie. Not pull it this time. Do not pull it. Press the bottom. Doo-doo. And now the top. Doo-doo. And it will be hinged back on into place so it won't rely as heavily on the Velcro. Now for this section of the table, this is end. So it'll be moving to the end of my name. We are done here with our maintenance check. And so we can go back to the main location for which these escapes will take place. This will be the end of this tape. Now Freddy is in full operation. He will now be able to perform again. I thank you for joining me on this tape, and the next tape will be on what to do if a danger happens.